What's up, Mariners? This is Abhilash Thakur, and welcome to Sailor's Guide. As you have seen on the thumbnail of this video, we are going to fill up the SCBA bottles by using the SCBA compressor. So without wasting our time, let's get started.
So I'll show you step by step how you fill it. And please make sure that you read the instruction manual of the SCBA compressor, whichever you have on board. Please read the instruction manuals first, because there could be some steps which is different, but they are mostly the same. So I'm going to start. This is Junior 2, which we have the compressor here on board. It's the company name Junior, and the two model here. I'll show you the tag which is on top of it. Right, you can see it here, Junior 2. This is the compressor we have on board. So I hope most of the ships have the same compressor, or maybe more or less the same. And you can see here the instruction manual is we have tagged here, okay. And you need to read the instruction manual. It is very important you read it first, and then you operate the SCBA compressor, okay. So firstly, I'll show you some parts of it. Here you can see this is the gauge, okay. The gauge of the SCBA compressor, and this is very important, the O-ring, the rubber packing you see here. This is called as the O-ring here. It should be present over here, otherwise if you connect it with the bottle, yeah, and when you will open the valve, all the air will leak from here, okay. So this O-ring should be present all the time. Same in the SCBA set, I have shown in the video which I have made earlier, okay. So here you can see this is the filter, primary filter. This is another filter. And here you see there are two valves here, okay. These are the relief valves. What it does, it releases the pressures, it releases the pressure which is inside this compressor, okay. What happens when the air compressor compresses the air, it compresses the water molecules inside it, and water get condensed between the lines, okay. Water get condensed between the system, so you have to relieve the valves so that the water can come out from these pipes. See it here, I'll show you how it's done. So first step, and one more thing is important, that this SCBA compressor should be connected with the emergency generator supply, because in case of emergency, if the power supply cuts off, the emergency generator will start automatically. So this SCBA compressor must be connected with the emergency generator input, okay. This must be connected with the emergency generator supply. Okay, so this one is connected with the emergency supply. We have already checked it. It is also considered as a PSC deficiency if it is not connected to the emergency generator. Okay, so now I'm going to connect the connector here. Before that, I have to run the SCBA compressor dry run as per the instruction manual for 1 minute. Okay, so I have a watch here. For 1 minute, we will run it. The dry run, you have to open up the relief valve where see the air is coming out from here. If any water droplets inside the system, it will come out, okay. You need to close it again, otherwise the pressure will leak. In 1 minute, we have run this compressor. Let's switch it off. Okay, now we will connect this connector with the bottle. And also, you have seen here that I have kept the bottle inside the water, because when you fill up the air inside this while using this SCBA compressor, this bottle gets hot. Okay, because of the pressure, it gets hot. The temperature goes up. So with the help of the water, you keep the temperature of the bottle more or less the same. you don't let it rise, because when the temperature goes down, the water condenses to the sides of the walls of the SCBA bottle, so which we don't want, because this air has to be breathed in by the people who are wearing the SCBA set. So we should not let the water condense inside the bottle. So let's start connecting this connector to the bottle. Okay, before connecting the connector, you need to check the O-ring must be present here. You see it's in a good condition and it is present here. And now you can connect the connector to the bottle. Just rotate it clockwise. Okay, so the connector is connected right now, and you can just check few things before starting the compressor. You need to check this is the relief valve for this connector. Okay, what is the function of it? I'll let you know later in the video. Okay, so you need to close it. Yeah, tightly. And then you need to close the relief valves here. You need to close these relief valves. Close it properly. Alright, so the next step is you need to open up the portal. Yeah, you see the pressure is about 170 here. You need to fill it up to 200. So now you can start the compressor. Always keep an eye on the pressure so that you don't over pressurize the bottle. So this bottle pressure maximum you can fill up to 207 bars. Okay, 207 bars you can see here. So the working pressure 207. For the safe end you can put 210, then you can stop. Okay guys, so the pressure is 210 now. We will switch it off. Okay, so the pressure is 210. We have switched off the SCBA compressor. Now the first thing you need to do is to close this valve so that the pressure doesn't get out. The air should be preserved. Yeah, so close it properly. And the second step is to clear out the condensed water, if it is any water inside the system. Because of the pressurized air, the water gets condensed, as I've told you earlier in the video. So we need to do it by using the relief valves here. The system has been relieved. You see the pressure is dropped, but still you will see that you will not be able to open up the connector. So for that, this is the purpose of the relief valve for this connector. You need to open it up here. So now you see it can be opened easily. Okay, after disconnecting, you check the O-ring. You see the O-ring is present here. Okay, now put it back into the place. So that's how you fill up the bottle. Okay guys, so let's take this bottle down and check the pressure by using the pressure gauge which we have for the spare bottles, and so that we can make sure that it is fully filled up and keep it back into the place. Okay guys, so here I have the pressure gauge. I'll use this pressure gauge to check the bottle pressure. Okay, so I'll connect this pressure gauge here. Valve also, and you have connected the pressure gauge. Let's check the pressure. Yeah, you see here it is more than 200, close to 205. It is okay. Now you need to open up the relief valve, and you can disconnect it.
I hope you find this video helpful. If you find this video helpful, please press the like button and press the subscribe button so that you don't miss the videos which are going to come in the future. Also, if you have any questions regarding the Merchant Navy, you can put down in the comment below so that I can make new videos on the new topics. Until then, this is Abhilash Thakur signing off.